Tuesday, we're down at the Sagebrush Theater this afternoon where Silent Chap is just about to get underway. It's running from February 20th to March 1st, and here's the guy. No stranger to midday, of course, Alan Corbishley. So
Hi.
Good to have you on.
Thank you again.
Yes, I am really honored to be sitting here talking to you because I know that this has been a huge deal for you.
Mm-hmm.
You got your own Western Canada Theatre performance. Tell me about this.
It's huge. It's such an honor. Like, they've really just given me the biggest gift anyone could really give an artist. So it was it's a couple of years in the making in that Jeremy Tao, when he was the artistic director for his short tenure until his passing, unfortunately, he knew that I had this idea of this show and said, why don't we develop it? And I was like, okay, great. So brought on Kevin Kerr and Kim Collier just for for a bit of a work through just to see its potential. They are internationally renowned artists, but they actually come from Kamloops, which is great. They run Electric Company in Vancouver, and they thought it had great, great potential. So Kevin Kerr came on as dramaturg, which is a term we use for, you can think of it as a developer or an editor for a playwright. And he came on and worked on it with me for like a year and a half or so. And then when Daryl came on as artistic director, we workshopped it, and then he said, yeah, let's take the plunge and do it.
So you created this. Tell me what that means.
I came up with the concept like back in 2006. And I was thinking about me being from an opera world, what a play would be like with just a musical score and no text, and so like a mute opera of sorts. Some people would say that's a dance piece or what have you, but it's a physical theater piece which exists. The Overcoat was an example of that, that kind of toured around the world. And so I came up with, I looked into Charlie Chaplin as just a possible subject matter, which made sense to a silence and stuff. And he was kind of a gold mine in material and background and controversy and just a fascinating, fascinating man. And not really at all what you think of him as. And then that spurred on the idea of why is, when we think of Charlie Chaplin, we think of his character on screen. We don't think of him as a person, and we don't register all of the things that were going on in his life. And so there's a total disconnect between the reality of him and what we think of him. And so that's kind of the background of this whole show.
It examines the relationship between Charlie Chaplin and the tramp.
That's right. And his creation, yeah.
Do we learn more from this play, as the result of this play, a little bit more about who Charlie Chaplin was then?
I think so. I think I hope so. We learn about his personal life a little bit in that his relationships, and his relationships were always a bit deemed questionable in that he was always in a relationship with someone who was 16, regardless of how old he was. So his first relationship, he was 28, and she was 16. The next one, he was 35, and she was 16. And then he met Una O'Neill, Eugene O'Neill's daughter, when he was 54, and she was 16.
That lucky number 16.
Yeah, and so we play with that, we explore that. And but then, him and Una were married for 30 years and had 8 children, and it was a true love affair. And they were very dedicated, and she was very dedicated to him, and it was a really special relationship. So,
was he in love with the idea of youth? Was that a thing for him?
No. When you look at the research, he actually fell in love when he was 16 with a girl at the time who was also 16. And so it seemed to kind of, and her parents wouldn't let her date him because he was a poor actor. And said, don't even bother with this guy. He's not worth it. So she wasn't allowed to date him. And so I think that just stuck with him and it kind of ingrained some sort of fetish of sorts in him.
Sure.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about the fact that this is a silent performance. Mm-hmm. It's not silent musically, but there is no spoken word. Does that add, or has it added to the challenge of getting your message across?
It kind of clears it up a little bit. But there is dialogue. There is a very little bit at the very end of the show. And the dialogue actually shows up in titles like you would in one of his films. So dialogue boxes come up. So there is dialogue through the show, we just don't actually speak it. Mm. And so I think it's fun. The music becomes the texture, the voice of the show. And so it's fun for the actors, or it's different for the actors. The whole process is different. They're taking away their instrument, and so they have to communicate in other ways. And you know, he's known for that, and his antics and his gags, and but also the sadness and the realness and humanity and in the stories.
It sounds like a fantastic performance, Alan. What would you say, in a nutshell, it is that you want members of the audience to take home with them after this performance is over?
Oh Lord, I want them to understand a little bit more about Charlie Chaplin. I want them to think about art and artist, celebrity, perception of all that, and just perception of who we think people are and who they are in reality.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, I want to say break a leg. I'm sure it's going to go fantastically, and congratulations on a job well done.
Thank you. It's the congratulations actually goes to the company and to all the tech support, and it's such a huge show, and they've done like an amazing job, and it's a big undertaking for them, and it was stretching them just in regards to new capacities, and they've done just an amazing job, and I think it shows for it.
Fantastic. Yeah. Silent Chap is taking place here at the Sagebrush Theater, effective now, right through until March 1st. You can get your tickets at the Camel's Live box office. Promises to be a great production. We're going to take a quick break, more midday when we get back. Stay with us.